turn to you, Tanks, because I know you did a deep dive on this matchup. It's fascinating from a fan's perspective. What did you find?
Well, what I found is the way Genzel is playing, we saw with the week that he had last week with his partner, Crosby, and Rust, they're having a terrific season. And who are they going to play against tonight? Erik Karlsson and Brendan Dillon. So I'm looking forward to see them. The Crosby line, they're like hound dogs. Look at how close they are to one another. You know, in an NHL area now where guys like to have room, like to spread the puck, they like to play close and tight together. They do the short picks, they do the short give and goes, and they're always first on puck. Look at the effort from Russ there to get himself to the high slot, you know, to get themselves into position. Crosby's behind the net. Genzel in a position where he moved his feet. All of a sudden, Crosby wins the puck. Russ keeps going. He keeps getting open. Who wins the puck battle? Again, Sidney Crosby. They're like hound dog on the puck. Look at Crosby here. He stops on the puck. He loses the puck. Oh, all of a sudden, he's got that puck again. And look at the other two. You know, they close together. All of a sudden, you know, not Russ on that play. Kessel gets open on the back door. I like the body of work, the puck movement that they do, the way that they're unselfish in the way that the puck always goes ahead, not slowing down anybody in the neutral zone. And does anybody compete harder than 87 on the ice? And when he does, that team is just absolutely spectacular. What else can we say about Genzel? We look at the playoffs and the way that he played the last couple years. Well, they're going to be there. A lot of teams in the Eastern Conference don't want to play them. And on the San Jose Sharks, who's going to play against them tonight? 65. 65, Peter DeBoer said, not only at the start of the season, he was trying to find his way offensively, but he was also trying to find his way defensively. What I like about his game is the way to skate. He's a fast skater. We saw it just there. He closed the gap. And when you close the gap and you don't give room to the opposition, you're going to be able to feed your team into transition like that. I like the way that he moves the puck. And when you get it here, look at the players on his team are all inside the blue line. They're all very close. Karlsson's got the puck. Okay, let's go. Let's take off because we know he can make a good first outlet pass. Look at the distance of which he makes that puck. All the forwards are gone now. They're not looking forward to see where the puck is coming from. They know that 65 in black is going to be able to make a good pass. Great execution, transition. They did not score on the play, but they got a great 3-on-2 transition out of it. And look at him. He always steps ahead, you know, as a defenseman. He always steps ahead. He always makes that first pass, that transition. He's a fast skater. He's a tremendous, you know, offensive player. But when his defensive, you know, play is this way, where he skates, where he closes gaps, you know, it's going to provide the San Jose Sharks the ability with the fact that Vlasic and Braun, who's just been back in the lineup, missed a lot of time, who usually play against the top line on the other side. To have Erik Karlsson being able to play against the top line on the other side is certainly reassuring for Peter DeBoer.